So now that that's finished, we move on to the next step, which is painting and cleaning up. And this is easily the most time-consuming bit of my process. Cleaning up everything has the potential to be really super tedious, so don't forget to take breaks, watch some TV, take a nap, play some games, do whatever you want, take some breaks. So anyway, the basic gist of this is just going over and cleaning up what you don't want in the final painting by painting over it. So this includes painting over the parts of the sketch that you don't need, blending colors together, smoothing out lines, and kind of just carving out the more refined picture that you want out of the rough foundation that you've set for yourself so far. This is the part where having a cleaner sketch might make things that much easier, since there will ideally be less for you to clean up now. While this is definitely the longest part of the process, it's probably one of the simplest concept-wise, as it's really just eyedropping colors that you've already put down and using them to clean up what you already have. And as you clean up, it's pretty likely that you'll come across mistakes, and you can just fix them by painting over them or transforming them or using whatever method of correction that you find the most effective and comfortable for you and your preferences. Some corrections that I make a lot are ones with the eyes and with like the placement of the head and the neck and shoulders and stuff like that. 9 times out of 10, I just color over the eyes that I sketched and start entirely from scratch with those. I'm rarely ever happy with the eyes that I sketch out. I also move around the nose and the mouth a lot until they're in places where I want them to be. And then I just clean up everything around them in the face so that everything is pretty and neat and tidy. So really, you can do whatever you want. I mean, it's your drawing after all. Don't be too afraid to change things, because usually it's not permanent if you end up not liking what you change. A lot of times during this step, I also still use a lot of layers. Sometimes I'll paint on one layer. Sometimes I don't. It really doesn't make that much of a difference, and it just depends on how I'm feeling. Usually I try to use as few layers as I can, because I tend to get really lost in layers and I just make a whole lot of layers for no reason. So I try to keep the number of layers I use low. I'm not really sure if I succeeded with that here. Anyway, I do still use layers to like tweak colors and stuff like that using different layer styles. So if I think something is too dark, I'll color over it in another layer with like some dark or neutral related color, and then I'll set that to overlay or soft light or something to darken up the overall color a bit. Some stuff like that is what I'll use other layers for. Essentially what I'm saying is use as many or as few layers as you're comfortable with using, since they're there for you to use as you see fit after all. I mean, that's what they're there for. Oh, hair. Hair. I suppose I do hair a little differently than I do everything else in this process as far as cleanup goes. My sketches are messy, but the hair in them is super messy, so instead of just painting over the bits of the sketch that I don't want like I do with the rest of the painting, I tend to just paint over the entire general shape of the hair with the colors that I want the hair to be, with it being like vaguely darker in areas where it should be darker, like in hair parts or in the underside of the hair. And then after that is done, I just redraw the appropriate lines where they should be. It works out a lot more efficiently for me that way. I don't do it all in one chunk, but I do it in like bits and pieces. Like I'll do, you know, like half of the hair and then the other half and then the bang and etc. Like it's not necessary to do it all at once, but you can if it's easier for you that way. You can do whatever you want. That aside, as you clean, you can add in more small details like specific folds in the clothing and creases in uniforms and all the little details in the eyes and things like that. These details become so much easier to add when things are cleaner, so when you're cleaning up, you'll find it a lot more, I don't know, easy and doable to add in those small details. They're also much easier to add the larger your canvas size is, which is probably something I should have brought up earlier now that I think about it. But since we're here, My canvas size in this drawing is 3,000 by 4,500 pixels, but once everything is finished in the end, I'll resize it to something a lot smaller and more manageable to save and do whatever with, you know. But yeah, the bigger the canvas size is, it's a lot easier to do those little details and keep things like really smooth and neat. So with the skirt, I did something similar to what I usually do with the hair. Like, I just colored over the whole thing and then put in lines where they should be. It's a really handy technique if things are a little messier than you anticipated they would be, which is quite often the case in my experience.
Thank you.
closer to being finished as far as painting Sakura went. I finally decided what I wanted to do with the sky. So on a different layer, I covered it in purple and messed around with the layer styles until I came across one that effectively conveyed what I wanted the background to look like. And I guess in this case, the layer style happened to be color burn, but it could be whatever. Whichever layer style looks the best and you like the most. I mean, try out a bunch of different ones. I did. I put it on pretty much all of them before I decided on color burn. So try out different things and see how they look. I guess this is a really good time to say that you can really change whatever you want, no matter how late you are in a painting. So don't ever get too concerned about the permanence of anything. Like, I did not know what I wanted to do with the sky until this part in the drawing, and I still managed to do what I wanted to do. So never feel too worried about not having a totally concrete image of what you want to be drawing and be, I don't know, you know what I'm saying? Like, don't get too concerned about not knowing exactly what you want to paint.
As long as stars are above you, however long you say,
that I went into hue and saturation as usual and messed around with the different colors a bit to see what my options were before I finally settled on a final color choice, and then I merged everything down to one layer again. At that point, I had another layer where I edited Sakura's colors a little bit to fit more with the background, and at that point I decided I wanted her to be holding her little wand, so I painted that in as well while I cleaned up the clouds in the background behind her. So once you're done with all that cleaning up and refining, you're essentially done with the painting. Congratulations! At the very end, I add in the little hair shines and some eye shines and pretty much just shines everywhere in a gigantic unholy shine free-for-all. I added in some really simple stars, and I fiddled around with the colors a bit more before flattening everything down to one layer and then resizing it to something more manageable and then saving it as a PNG. And that's the end. I'm done, and you're done. Congratulations for making it to the end. Special shout out to all the people who are supporting me on Patreon. You guys are the absolute best. So these super fabulous people are Concept? I can't read, so this is gonna be that. Concept, Mattia Aletta, Tina, Rebecca, Jessica, Sean, Raph Dazzle Plantist John, Forest Pikes, Cappuccino, Christina, and Isangelus? I don't know if I read any of those right. I know I made tons of errors, but you guys are the best. I love you guys. Thanks so much to everyone for watching this video and for keeping up with me and my drawings. I really appreciate it, and I will catch you guys later.